workbook, we deal with depreciation. And this example that you see here on the straight line depreciation sheet, SLN, we buy an asset for $10,000. The salvage value is going to be $4,000. And the lifetime of the asset is 3 years. So if you have a straight line depreciation, you basically take the difference between the cost and the salvage and divide it by the number of years. So in this case, we are going to use a function. It's going to be a financial function, which is called SLN. And when you activate it, it's going to ask you for the cost. I'm going to use absolute addressing. The salvage, I'm going to use again absolute addressing. And the lifetime of the project, absolutely addressed. So over the next 3 years, you're going to be depreciating $2,000 a year. If you sum it, it's the $6,000 that we are depreciating. On the next sheet, we are dealing with the sum of the year's digits example or method of depreciation. This time, it's an accelerated depreciation. So at the very beginning, you depreciate a much higher amount, and towards the end, you depreciate less. If you want to know how to do it manually, you have to add the number of years, 1 plus 2 plus 3 in this case. For the first year, you're using 3 over the 6. The second year, you use 2 over the 6. And the last year, it's going to be 1 over the 6. But we have an Excel function. We are going to use function, financial. And the one we use is the sum of the year's digits. It's going to ask you for the cost. This is the initial cost, absolutely addressed. The salvage, again. And the lifetime of the asset. The only thing that is changing from year to year, I forgot to do it absolutely addressed. The only thing that is changing from year to year is the period. It's going to be first period, second period, and so on. And if you drag it down or double click, the first year is going to be 3,000, 2,000, and 1 over 6 is 1/6 of the amount, 1,000. And if you add it up, this is the sum of the depreciations. As you notice, in the first year, the depreciation is much higher than in the second or the third. Another system is to use the declining balance depreciation. I have two different examples. The first example on the left in column E, we assume that we start at the beginning of the year. The cost is the same, 10,000. The salvage is 4,000, and the lifetime of the project or the asset is 3 years. And we're going to use the declining balance. The example on the right assumes that you start in the middle of the year. In the example we have, we are going to start and maybe in August, where you have only, or September, we have only 3 months left. So let's start with a simple example where we start at the beginning of the year. We are going to use function, declining balance. The cost is here, F4. The salvage, again, is absolutely addressed. And the lifetime of the asset is 3 years. Period is changing. First year, then it's going to be second year, and then it's going to be third year. I ignore the optional months, which we're going to show in the second example. So by default, it's going to be zero. And if you sum, you're going to see in the beginning that the declining balance has a very high depreciation, and it decreases over time. If you sum it up, it's about 6,000 plus minus a few dollars here and there. The second example shows us the declining balance where you start the project in the middle of the year. In this example, we have only 3 months left for the first year. So if we use a calendar year, we are assuming that we're starting in October. So we have October, November, December left. So we are going to use the same function, declining balance. Cost is the same cost. The salvage is the same salvage. The lifetime of this asset is going to be 3 years. The period is changing. So it's going to be first year, second year, third year. So I'm not absolutely addressing it. And then the month, since we're starting, we're going to have only 3 months left in the project, I'm going to have it also absolutely addressed. And when you say, okay, yes, it's the first year, but we have only 3 months left for depreciation. Second year, third year, and fourth year is the balance. And if you sum it, it should be about $6,000 again. So these are the three depreciation methods shown to the exercises we had for the depreciation file. The first example, we have a cost of $5,000, salvage of $1,000, and the lifetime of the asset is 4 years. So we are going to use the same straight line depreciation function under SLN. The cost is here. The salvage is 1,000, and the lifetime of the asset is 4 years. And we are going to say, okay, you will discover that the difference of $4,000, 5,000 minus 1 divided, 1,000 divided by 4 is $1,000 a year, and the sum is the $4,000 of depreciation. The second exercise is about the sum of the year's digits. Of course, it adds the sum of the years, so it's going to be 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. The first year it's going to be 4 over the 16 of the sum of 10. The second year it's going to be 3, and so on and so forth. We are going to use the function, and this time we use the sum of the year digits function. This is the cost, the salvage, the lifetime, and the period is changing. So the first year we are going to depreciate 4 over the sum of the years, which is 10, and so on and so forth. So as you see, the beginning, it's an accelerated depreciation. In the beginning, you depreciate much more than towards the end. And then the sum should be about $4,000. The last example is dealing with the accelerated declining balance depreciation. The first example is where we start in January, or the calendar year of the depreciation. The second example, we assume that only 2 months are left in the first year. So let's start with the first example. We're going to use the function which we call declining balance. This is the cost, the salvage, the lifetime, and the period is changing from year to year. So it's going to be C9, C10, and so on and so forth. And when you say OK and drag it down or double click, you're going to get the 4 different depreciations for the 4 years. The sum is around $4,000. The second example, we have the same exact asset, except as we say, there are only 2 months left into the calendar year or the accounting year. So we are going to use the same function, declining balance. Again, the cost is absolutely addressed. I'm using a 4. Salvage is absolutely addressed. The lifetime of the project is 4 years. And the period is changing. It's going to be the first year, second year, third year, and so on. So it's not absolutely addressed. And the first year, we say that we are going to start, if it was a calendar year, in November, so we have only 2 months left. And you'll see that in the beginning, instead of 1655, it depreciates less. And these are the declining balance depreciations for the 4 years of the project. If you sum it, it should be again close to $4,000. So these were the solutions to